Hey kids, today we're making no churn bubblegum ice cream.
It's YouTube's best for creative things. It's cooking and crafting.
Hey kids. We're back and we're making some bubblegum no churn ice cream, and I want to thank my niece Gracie for asking me to please do some no churn ice creams, because I am having a ton of fun trying to come up with different things to do, and this was the latest. So what we want to do is we want to put in 2 cups of heavy cream, and we're going to add some food coloring to this. I had actually gone out and purchased some some Wilton coloring, but I remembered when I went to VidCon that I had received these colors free when Jen, who is Cupcakes and Cardio, was there with Makers and Bakers, and they were giving those away free. Whip this up until stiff peaks form, and we will add more fun things to it. And we have stiff peaks. So the next thing we're going to do is we're going to add this candy and baking flavor in bubblegum flavor. Now this says that it's super strength, 4 times stronger than extracts. So we're going to go a little easy on this, because normally you would put like a teaspoon of vanilla extract. But if this is 4 times the strength, we want to go a little easy. We're going to go maybe about a half of a teaspoon, and then we'll see how that tastes when this is blended up. And we're gonna add, I can already smell it, it's quite a bit. And we're adding in a 14-ounce can of sweetened condensed milk. And we're gonna beat this until the color is uniform. It's all mixed in there well. So we'll bring you back when that's completed. It did end up needing more flavoring as I gave it a little bit of taste, so I added in the rest. Alright, so I'm going to put in about 1/3 to 1/2 of the whipped ice cream, and then the gumballs that I cut in half, I'm going to add those in, part of that in now. Now the reason why you would cut these up is I found out some people had suggested that freezing them made them easier to cut, but they really weren't, and really they were like jawbreakers basically. And I found that that would be a little on the dangerous side, especially for younger kids, with this being bubblegum. So don't freeze them, because they also allowed the color, the coloring to kind of come off on the chopping board, and I would rather the color come off in the ice cream versus the chopping board. And I would suggest when you have your kids eating this, when they get a bubble gum, to just pull it out, put it on the side, and then when they're done with their ice cream, then get their gum and chew their gum, because, like I said, jawbreakers, not fun if you end up having a child choke on it. I love the color of this. This is just absolutely beautiful. This is the Color Right Rosa by Wilton, the new Color Right. And now we're going to top these with more bubble gum. And it would probably be prettier if, you put them like that, just for pretty pictures or whatever. The kids aren't going to care. If it's going to be for a birthday party, it would probably be more visually beautiful like that. And of course, there's always the food porn pics that you always take that always make everything look so much better because, you know, you eat with your eyes first, right? And I had some of these bigger gumballs. Oh, that kind of ruined. So I cut some of those up. But now this is going to go into the freezer overnight. Most of these no churns say after 5 hours you can eat them, but I found that it was just a little soft. But if you let it go for 24 hours, it is the same consistency as you would get from regular ice cream. So let it sit. Bubblegum, no churn ice cream. Once again, thank you, Gracie. Love you. And we'll be back when we serve this up.
If you like that ice cream that Auntie made, don't forget to smash that like button. Smash it with your bubblegum ice cream if you made one. And leave a comment.
And subscribe.
And subscribe.
And Bainey gives the thumbs up. That's the thumb that you should smash, right? Ooh.
Goodbye. Make sure you comment and subscribe and